Hello, I'm Dr. Bob Reinheimer, an executive director at Duke Corporate Education, and I'd like to take the next few minutes to describe how we design a program at Duke Corporate Education. If you look at what a dictionary says about the word design, many of the definitions contain the phrase art with a purpose. And I think that's very consistent with how we think about the process of building the right educational experience for our clients. There is a purpose to what we do, and we believe that there's a real art to pulling the right elements together so that a program has the impact that our clients desire. The purpose has to do with the fact that we believe that the reason our clients invest in education is to affect their business's performance. So when we talk about design, we talk about the process of developing perhaps a learning strategy, perhaps a curriculum, or perhaps a single learning experience, so that the participants who are affected by our work are able to strengthen the company's business performance. Many educational providers think about strengthening people and their competencies as the reason that education is invested in. We actually go further. We believe you invest in education to strengthen people in a way that drives better business performance. And our ability to connect business performance to learning, we believe, is one of our core strategic advantages. So that's the purpose of design, and the art of design is what I'm going to describe to you over the next few minutes. As you listen to how we think about the design process, you may see why, for the last 10 years, our business has been all about strategy execution through education. I'd like to show you something about the stages that we go through when we think about the process of design. We first talk about the process of discovery. And discovery means that we simply have to get to know the client's business almost as well as the client does. So we certainly want to understand the industry in which the client operates and something about the competitive context in which they compete. By understanding that business context, it gives us the opportunity to really begin the design process. That strategy then drives us to create a set of specific business outcomes that the learning is targeted at achieving. With that business context in mind, the next question is, who are the participants that we will be touching with this learning experience? And we try to answer two broad sets of questions about those people. First of all, who are these individuals in the organization and why are they the targets that have been chosen for this learning experience? What is the context that makes them important? And what is affecting them right now as a group of business people? What are they worried about? What are they conscious of trying to achieve? What does the world of their organization and their business look like from their chair? Once those broad foundational questions are answered, we then get down to designing the learning experience or learning experiences themselves. And that starts, first of all, with creating a specific set of learning outcomes. Once we know what the outcomes are, informed about who the participants are, and conscious of what the business context is, then we bring the real design of the content of the program and the methodology of the program into place. The methods question is, how can we use impactful, engaging ways of conveying that knowledge or giving the participants a learning experience so that they really acquire what they need to acquire and those newly acquired ideas and behaviors stick with them and can be used in an impactful way? We have an entire group at Duke CE called the Learning Methods Group, and they've spent years thinking about ways that adults learn, and we use their expertise to design methods that fit those adult learning patterns. Before I design a program, I need to know the business, I need to know the people, but the bottom line for me is to understand how these participants are supposed to be different because they have gone through a learning experience that we have created on their behalf. And differences for us fall into three broad categories. First of all, they should know something that they didn't know when the program began. Secondly, what do we want the participants to do or do differently as a result of this program. So there's a behavioral dimension. It may be new skills, it may be changing behaviors, it may be acquiring new behaviors. The third piece that we think about very seriously and that may not be as typically thought of by educational providers is the third set of outcomes. What do you want these participants to believe as a result of being in this program? We are not shy about acknowledging the fact that many educational investments have a persuasive agenda, and so we want to understand what people need to believe as a result of the program in addition to what they need to know and do. If we can stay focused on what people know, what people do, and what people believe, we think we've got a very good handle on exactly what a learning investment is supposed to achieve. And achieving those learning outcomes means that we have an impactful program for our clients. When we think about what a good design looks like, we need to be able to tell a story that describes the whole learning experience that participants go through. We talk about this as a storyline. By the time we've finished a design, we've thought about the outcomes, we've put together the content, we've put together the experiences, and we think that that flow needs to have a narrative behind it that helps us think about how we design the pieces of the program, and we think that narrative needs to be discernible to the participants so they understand the learning journey that we have created on their behalf. So a storyline runs through the entire program, and it ultimately connects the learning experience back to the participant's business context and back to the organization's strategy. So by the time the participants understand the storyline, they get a sense of what they're going to go through, and we've given them a pretty good answer to why they're going through it. This is an example of a very straightforward storyline that was a part of one of the programs we've done recently. This company hatched a global strategy, so the first part of the program was all about understanding that big picture. Secondly, we focused on helping each leader understand his and her role in making that big strategy successful. And thirdly, we wanted to get down to very concrete action planning so that each of these leaders could leave this learning experience with a set of concrete things that she or he would do to bring that larger strategy to life. This is the program that came out of that storyline. Day one is the big picture. Day two is built around helping people understand the role that they play in bringing that strategy to life. And day three was built around giving them the opportunity to do action planning. This is a typical way that a storyline plays out in the overall design of a program. When you get involved with a project for Duke CE, you're going to find that you work most closely with a core project team. They own the relationship with the client, and they have responsibility for the success of the project. But that core project team calls on another set of resources depicted in the orange orbit, and that set of resources is what makes each project unique and how we ensure that each project has the right resources to get the job done. We bring in the right educators using our global learning resource network to source the right people for the right task. We bring in learning methods to make sure that this is an impactful learning experience for every adult participant. We also bring in learning technology where appropriate and other resources like executive directors to help think about the design and the delivery of every program. The entire enterprise is also supported by a robust administrative team who ensures that wherever we're doing business in the world, we're doing it right. So that is a brief overview of how we think about designing a program at Duke Corporate Education. At the beginning of this message, I talked about the notion that design is art with a purpose. And if you think about that analogy and carry it forward a little bit, we take the colors that we have and we assemble them to create a uniquely impactful learning experience at the intersection of business and education.